Hell yeah.
Well, lucky, lucky, lucky me, the birds have flew the coop and left the nest. They left Daddy here to clean his boat up. Look at that mess. And try to get everything ready to go to Florida. But this, where this thing's been sitting, I've had a time. I got a stopped up vent line on my septic, had to pull the tanks out, swap the fuel pump. It's going to be a heck of a show, man. But y'all bear with me. Maybe we'll get this thing back on the water and get to catch some fish down there offshore, hopefully this weekend or maybe even this week.
Captain Kelly, why am I not catching fish?
Because you're a sucky fisherman.
No. So I got me an overdose of rock and roll.
Yay! They flew away. Time to get busy with this bad boy. I'm ready to go to Florida. Yes, sir. I got new glasses today and got the boat uncovered. So far, it's been a good day. But boy, she's nasty. Good morning, everybody. And when you see this, happy belated Mother's Day to all the mamas out there. I'm gonna get up and go see my mama here pretty quick. But I'm gonna copy Matt from Sailing Good, Bad, and Ugly. Sailing, I say sailing, you know, like I'm sailing something, but it's what it sounds like, but sailing, sailboat. Sailing Good, Bad, and Ugly. Matt and Kristen, I love watching those guys. But Matt used a term I'd seen I thought was hilarious. And I mean, maybe it's been around a while, I'd never heard it, but it's called boat yoga. If you got a boat, a big boat, especially a big boat, you know exactly what boat yoga means when you hear it, because the positions you have to get in to do stuff is just defies the human body, what it's able to do, but we get it done. So I got to unwinterize this bad boy. I got to do some boat yoga. Started cleaning on it yesterday. Old girl's looking really good. So, got to get in here, unwinterize it, check everything out. I'm probably going to swap my fuel pump. Not an easy job to do on this boat. I've done this twice. I bought a cheap fuel pump the first time. It got me through one season, did excellent. It set over the winter, wouldn't start in the spring. Well, I say cheap. It was cheaper than a Mercury factory pump. So I was very, very disappointed, and I contacted the people that I'd ordered it through, and they just really wouldn't do anything about it. I'm like, dude, it's less than a year old. I mean, I put it on in like August, and by April of the following year, and this boat set from October, steering, and by April, it wouldn't start. It wouldn't work anymore. And I was very upset, but they wouldn't help me. So I ordered another one just like it, but from a different company, a different brand. But it looks identical to it. I think they're both made on the same assembly line. And kept it as a spare. And I got the old original pump that was on this boat in, this boat's a 99 model. So I got the old original pump from 99 and took it out here and beat on it a little while, got it to working. Well, it's done great, but the pressure switch in it, sometimes if you use it regular, it does fine. If it sits for a while, it wants to overpressurize, you know, and flood your carburetor and just burn raw fuel, and that's not good. So I'm going to put the new pump that I bought last year on for a backup for this Florida trip, because I do trust it over one that's dumping too many fumes into that, you know, into that engine compartment. I don't need a big boom boom out on the ocean. That's the last thing I need. So I'm going to go ahead and do that and try to order me another fuel pump, except this one will be from Mercury, and they're really expensive. Man, they're, whew, Mercury thanks a lot of them, but I've done had to do this. This will be the third time that I've actually swapped this fuel pump in less than 2 years, and I don't want to do it again. So, and I don't have time to wait for Mercury to get me a pump. So I'm going to put the new one that I got for a backup on here, and we're going to run it. We're going to go with it. And then I'll have to do it one more time. Maybe this will last a while, but I'm still going to order a Mercury for a backup pump and throw it in here. And when this one goes down this year, next year, the next year, whatever, I'll put the Mercury on it. So let's get in there and do some boat yoga. stretch these guns out, you know. I dread it. Man, I dread it. I ain't gonna be able to walk when I get through with this. But, hey, you know, you take the good, you take the bad, take them both, and there you have the facts of life. So, oh well.
My waste tank was acting funny last year. When I tried to dump the waste tank, have it sucked out, it was trying to collapse my tank. And I think I've got a vent tube stopped up or something. So, since I got to swap that fuel pump anyway, I can go ahead and get, I got my water tank already out and sitting to the side because it's already been drained. I had some paint winterizing antifreeze stuff in there already. So I'm going to go ahead and dump it out, flush it out real good with a hose pipe because just small water tanks in this boat, there's not a lot to them. And your waste tank's the same size. So I'm going to go ahead and pull the waste tank out too and clean it out with Clorox, you know, and kind of blow it back out where it's kind of collapsed on me a little. See how it's kind of sucked in? And that's not good. So we're going to put this thing in the sun. And if we ever get any sun again, it's freaking trying to rain again, but I'm going to put this thing in the sun. I'm going to wash it out real good with a hose pipe, probably fill it plumb up with water, and just let it sit out there and expand that tank back out and get the creases out of it. And that gives me way, way more room to get in here and unwinterize and work. And this needs to be done anyway, so I may as well knock it all out at one time because it's going to take me a little time to pull this out. You know, just a few minutes to unhook everything. It's just straps that hold it in, but you got to unhook your waste tank line and stuff. It's going to take me a few minutes to get that done, but it's going to save me so much time and give me so much more room to where I don't have to do as much yoga stretching. It'll be all worth it. I'm more than happy to do it. So, since I'm messing with the waste tank, I guess I will be a shitologist trying to figure out what's going on with my toilet. So, yeah, that's why I got my old beast mode shirt on. I should say poo mode. Okay, I definitely got a stopped up vent on my waste tank. And when I pulled it loose, I could see trash in it. So I'm going to try to blow it out with air hose or suck it out the vacuum, use a water hose, something, you know, just kind of so I can't fix it. But that'll fix my problem. And I'm debating on taking this waste tank out now because there's a little bit of waste still in it. I really don't want to pull this tank out. There's still about, like I said, you ain't much waste in there, and I don't know whose it is. It's probably mine. I mean, you know, I don't know who else it would be, but me or the family or whatever, but I dread pulling this line, so, all right. It's a shitty job, but somebody's got to do it. All right, well, she's done. I got the tank pulled out. I had, looked like grass, and dirt dauber, mud, and bugs and crawled in that vent hole, and that's what was causing my problem. So, you ever seen Robin Williams' RV? The movie, the movie RV, when he's dumping his tank, and it's like a poo geyser flies up in the air? Well, it wasn't that bad. Pulled the line loose, I had it capped with my hand, and brought it up out, and it was mainly just antifreeze. So, I was blessed on that deal, but I'm still going to wash these tanks out real, real good. Fill that one up with water. Try to expand it back out the way it's supposed to be. Clean the vent out on the tank. The vent from the tank to the outside of the boat is clean. It looks good, so whew, I'm glad that's over. But everything, that's your poo tank, your dark water tank, gray water. And that one there is your fresh water tank. So while I got them out, I'm going to put a little Clorox in both of them. Slosh it around. There's a big old washer. Slosh it around and you know, clean any bacteria. Get away from me, dude. Go on. Go on. I don't want none of this. That's what I thought. But anyway, I'm going to clean it out real good and it'll be ready to go back in the boat when I'm done working on the boat. So I took a hammer and just lightly tapped on this side of the crease after I filled the tank up with water. And I've let it sit outside a couple days, and it's cleaning right up. Look at that sun streak. I'm angelic. Oh. All right, checking your pump is a very, very simple thing to do. Unplug your old one. Plug your new one in. Lay it up there so it don't ground out. And bump your key.
As you can see, the pump was moving, so it's getting power. These pumps don't run direct off the battery, they run off the alternator. So whenever your alternator's turning over and putting power out, that's what makes your pump engage. Well, this had started leaking. This is a reservoir for your lower unit. And what it does is, there's a warner in there, a little warning thing in here, and it starts beeping if it gets below your full line and gets to the add. And what it does, it feeds a little bit of fluid, gear oil, back through this tube. And it goes back here to your lower unit. And when it gets back to your lower unit, you know, it just makes sure it keeps it topped off all the time to get a leak or something. And it's kind of greasy right now because I use degreaser, Simple Green, that stuff. And it comes with a little spray bottle. It's a Pro HD. That is some really good stuff for getting this grease all up. But this had started leaking, and it got on the belt, and it slung that mess all over this freaking boat. So it was a nightmare. And I've had it running earlier after I got it done winterized, and kind of slung some more, cleaned that belt off, because the belt was squealing, and I knew it wasn't too tight. But the fuel pump on this boat, on this Mercury, this is a 350 Merc. And sorry, I'm sniffing. I've got allergies real bad this year. But that's your fuel water separator. Need to change this thing every year. All right, your fuel comes through your line here out of your tank. Your fuel tank comes through your line, and it runs in your fuel water separator. Well, when it goes in here, of course, it does what it's called. It separates the water from your fuel in case you get a little bit of moisture and water in your fuel, or you get some bad fuel. And it lets that water settle down to the bottom, and it pulls the fuel off the top, and then it shoots it through here to this pump. And I can't see what I'm doing because I'm using my phone. Hopefully you can see it, but right here is the pump, this long cylinder thing. That's your pump, that's your fuel pump on this boat, on this model. It's electric fuel pump, and it carries it up through in here and right up around and right up to your carburetor. Now what you gotta do, you put a wrench on this inlet, break this loose, and go ahead and invest in some line wrenches. You can get them at Harbor Freight. They're really, really cheap, and it slips, you know, it's more closed than a regular wrench, and it keeps it from rounding off, because you will round that bad boy off if you ain't careful. You slip it on there and pop that thing off. And for $15, I think's what I give for them, it's worth every penny. I can't tell you how many of them I've tore up over the years working on boats and stuff I've had. But break that line loose right up here in the top. You'll see where the line goes in right there to the top of that fuel pump. You break that one loose, pull this line out of your way, go back under the bottom, right in there, put a wrench on this, break that line loose. Don't put a wrench on the very top up here. Put it right here beside it, because this housing will twist, and when it does, you'll lose your ground, you'll mess your pump up. Put your wrench right there, and put your wrench right there, and break it loose, and that pump will come, it'll push over, and then come out the top. And that's all it is to it. And it just plugs in right here. You got one plug. It's just a quick connect. So that's all you got to do putting these pumps in. There's nothing to them. I mean, they're simple to do. On this boat, you got to pull this line off out of the way, pull this line off out of the way, just two old clamps, just bend them back, and drop this serpentine belt. That way you got plenty of room and nothing in your way. It's simple to do. If you got any kind of mechanical abilities at all, you can do it. No, I mean, it's not a big deal. All right, what I'm holding in my hand, most of y'all know, is the blower tube, the vent tube for the blower. You got a tube coming in, a tube going out on these inboard engines to pull the fumes out of your compartment. If not, you could have an explosion, or you probably 99.9% chance you will have an explosion eventually. So I always try to keep my compartment clean, so if I have a gas leak or an oil leak or anything, it's going to show. Right now, the cleanest part of this boat is the engine compartment itself. So while I was in there cleaning, I've been flushing and cleaning and flushing and cleaning all damn morning. What you got to pay attention to is these tubes, especially when they start getting older and getting some holes in them and bad spots in them, you're not getting good ventilation whenever it's blowing the air back out from the blower or sucking it in on the opposite side. Well, what I've run into with this tube is pretty funky. But I found this bad boy in there. Now, you take this tube. Look at the size difference. That could be a bad, bad day. Very, very, very bad day. So, which this tube's not going back on. It's garbage. I'm going to get a new one. I replaced all of them, but that one last year, that one was in really, really good shape. So I didn't replace it. But I've got the cover pulled off. It just vents right here. On both sides, you'll have vents. Now, this one's set up from the factory to do an intake and an outtake, you know, to pull air in and push air out on the same side because it has a transom shower on the other side. So what I'm probably going to do is install a secondary blower so it's dragging more air in and pushing more air out. It would make me feel a whole lot better. There's something after my chickens. It made me feel a whole lot better and a lot safer on the water. Especially when you're offshore or something like that and you're trolling at slow speeds and that blower's running constantly. You want to get those fumes out of that compartment. When you got this lid pushed down, this will build up fumes, especially if your carburetor's overloading a little bit like mine is right now because it needs to be run. Well, you don't want that. If you don't get them fumes out of here, you will blow your boat up. You will have a fire. You will have a really, really bad day on the water. And you'll probably end up in the water swimming away from your boat. So check them lines yearly. Get down there and you'll pull them loose. Turn your blower motor on. Go over here to the outside on the other side of it. Put your hand up there. Make sure it's blowing out good. What I've done, I told you I'm like Tim the Tool Man Taylor. I want more power. I installed a secondary blower. So I'm going to mount my other blower down here above that trim tab line. Because trim tabs don't work anyway. I need to get some electric ones. And then I'll be ready to put the tanks back in and get back to cleaning. Now this is just a hard metal line here. It's a little bit kinked up. I'm not stressing that. I can pull most of it back out. This is just a secondary that I put on here. And the reason I use this harder line that's not as flexible is because it gets this riser. So if it gets a little warm, it ain't going to hurt a thing. But I had a heck of a time putting it on. I was trying to wire it in and my hand slipped and hit it. And this stuff bends really, really easy, but it'll be fine. They want you to use the vinyl. They tell you not to use this aluminum style, this aluminum foil style. Aluminum foil will not hurt as long as you keep it away from all of your wiring. Get that thing tied back. I've got mine tied up, I don't know if you can see it, to my rod holder. It's got everything pulled back away from my wiring so that I don't have to worry about that aluminum rubbing any wiring, rubbing a hole in it, and causing a short. But it won't hurt a thing as long as you keep an eye on it, keep it checked. They said because of Corona, nobody's got any right now. I went yesterday, I was trying to find some, and that's how much I could find. So it ain't really worth, you know. Go to Lowe's, get some 3-inch line if you got a 3-inch blower. I installed the second blower. Like I said, I want more power. It gets all the fumes out of here. This thing's like, you know, sounds like a rocket taking off when you kick it on. So I'm happy. Now I've got to get the poo tank back in, the water tank back in, clean up where I cleaned the belt off, wash this down one more time real good. It's unwinterized. I've got it running. She's almost ready to roll out of here. Now everything else is pretty much cosmetic. All right, I hope you learned a little something today. I've got a, this is where I was talking about putting your hands so you can feel your vents to see how they're blowing out. This was the input, sucks air in. This one blows out. Now both of these vents blow out. And over here on this side, this boat's also, you can hear it. This boat has got a fart fan. I call it like I see it, man. I'm not politically correct. So if you want political correctness, you're watching the wrong channel. But it's doing really well now. You can see how it's blowing. It also pulls the moisture out of the shower. Like when you're taking a shower, you can turn this fan on and it pulls that moisture out of the inside of the cabin, out of the shower. So I thought, well, let me check this. This line's in really good shape because it's pretty well protected except for right at the end. And I got this short piece to go over here to pull down pull down inside to let a little bit more airflow go directly into the engine compartment and when it's pulling air. So I thought, well, let me clean this out while I'm here. And I'm glad I did, because one, two, three, four, five, six wash nests in this side. So it's blowing great now. I mean, the air actually feels cool, like an air conditioner. So I'm glad I done that. I've got to attach this to my piece that goes in that hole. I don't know where I put it. There's a liner that goes inside of this. Input side, so it sucks the air in behind the transom shower, goes through the hull, blows back out the other side. No fumes, no troubles, no problems, no shirt, no shoes, no worries. And I made my transom shower longer using a brass fitting from an airline on one of my big trucks I've had over the years that I've had to work on. If y'all ever want to learn some big truck maintenance, let me know in the comments. I can show you a little bit of that. I can drop a transmission, a 13-speed transmission in a Kenworth, put it back in, clutch and everything, about 4 hours by myself. I've done it so many times, and it sucks. Well, I could. I'm a little older now. It may take me a little longer than four, but I could do it in 4 hours, which ain't too bad for one guy by himself. But now I got my extra long shower line. I can stand back here on my swim platform, do a stripper dance. I don't think nobody wants to see that, but I could if I wanted to. And she's ready to go. Clean all this mess up. Do some more washing. Probably a couple of hours worth of cleaning if I really get out there and boogie. Get it done quick. So, if you found this helpful and you learned a little something, like, subscribe, tell your mama and them about us, and ring that bell. Because Lord willing, we're going to Florida. Finally.
Hell yeah.
Why am I not catching fish?
Because you're a sucky fisherman.
No.